walking into the base camp. It's nice out today, man. It's like 40, probably 40 degrees, sunny, which is good for this time of year. Beautiful, beautiful day out. And I'm just going to the camp for a little bit today and do a little bit of renovation, making some subtle changes to the camp, cook up a little lunch. Really just a relaxing day out in the woods. Thanks for watching. Took a little bit of a spill coming up to the camp. Get the sun out my face. All right, checky out the fire pit.
Look at that. Look at them boulders, bro.
So last week, I did not bust out the camera, but I did get some work done here at the camp. I brought all kinds of rocks up here. So I'm not sure if this is the fire pit of choice. It's kind of freaking crazy. But yeah, I just want to show you guys all those rocks I brought up. All right, so what I was saying is, like, I don't know if this fire pit is legit or not, man. This thing's like 6 feet long, and it's got that little keyhole fire pit area for cooking on that rock, but it's just so huge, man. I'm gonna have to make my fire wall twice as large and make this cooking tripod bigger. Well, I guess we have something to do today then. All right, so basically what I'm gonna do out today, take what I've learned about the base camp and make some adjustments. So first thing I've learned is my base camp raised bed takes up too much space, and that since I built this and come up with the idea to build this, I've slept in a raised bed several times and it ain't all that nice. It's not that comfy. So what I'm thinking is somehow incorporating a hammock into this lean-to. I think what I'll do is disassemble my bed and use that wood. Wood's scarce around here. There's just not a whole lot of good, straight, dead standing wood to use for this shelter. So resources are limited. I wanna be able to use this space. So what I'll probably do is take the wood off of my raised bed to build my firewall up to make it the same length as my fire pit. Take this little rickety table and probably put it back here where the bed is. And then my idea is to hang a hammock to sleep in. But this raised bed, it's a cool bench, but I've got a chair right over here. So I don't really need a whole bench. So I'm gonna get my gloves on and start working. I'm getting me some coffee going this morning. So just breaking down some dry wood, dry stuff I had in my tinder bag. Get me a little, whatever you call this thing, Bush Buddy fired up. Before it gets too hot. Question is, can I get this thing level enough to hold my water? Look at that dark coffee, boy. No, I'm not like a coffee connoisseur by any means, but I like a good hot, warm, dark cup of joe every once in a while. Look at that steam, boy. All right, back to work. First thing I'm gonna do is just kind of clean up the area. Take this firewood, toss it out there. Get this bench, get this bed moved. Clean up the ground. About to be a real renovation today, boys. Cleaning out all this wood, found me a nice piece of white pine. Reason I'm hyped is 'cause this wood's this woodlands. There isn't really any good pine or cedar. There's a little bit, but it's nice to have this stuff. It's real soft wood, good for carving, good for feather sticking. Nah, I mean.
So here's my table. Trash, junk, man. This is what happens when you don't know what you're doing. You make things that suck. I think it's salvageable though. Well, I took out my table, I took out my raised bed. It's feeling nice and open now. The more and more I build out here, for a while I think, it's good, it's cool, I like it. And then it loses that cool factor pretty quick. I've always been kind of weird about layouts and how things are organized. Like for instance, when I was growing up, I used to rearrange my bedroom. So I moved my dresser over there, my bed over there, my TV and my Nintendo over there. I used to do that all the time. I mean, I still have that in my brain where once something's set, I'm like, eh, I don't like it. I want to change it. And I always change it. There's no way to please me. I just am always wanting to rearrange. Now that I cleared out this space, it feels so much better. I like it cleared out. The raised bed was a good idea. It provided something to sit on up off the ground. It was a bed. One, raised beds out of wood aren't that comfortable. It was a bench. And as a bench, it was okay. But as I sat on it, all the wood would flex and move. So if I was trying to, for instance, put my little bush buddy on top of that and make a coffee. Every time I sit on the bench, the whole bench moves. It's just not sturdy enough. I mean, it's heavy duty, it's sturdy, but it has give to it. So it was kind of iffy. Bed, not comfy. A bench, not real stable. And it took up so much space. I mean, the logs that I had it sitting on were all the way back against this back wall, but I couldn't put the bed all the way against the back wall or else there's no clearance. Even with this back wall in, you still don't have a whole lot of clearance back here if you did want to lay on it. So yeah, I tried it out, never got to spend the night in it, but that's okay because it wouldn't have been very comfortable. Since about a year ago when I started building this base camp, I've done two or three nights out on a raised bed. When I built it, I don't think I'd ever done one. So once I did one, I was like, yeah, you're not missing much. I'm sure there's a way to do it with small flexible branches, run them horizontally, I guess, make a little spring to it, maybe it feels better, but I don't know. But yeah, I got some more rocks over here for my fire pit.
So yeah, I got some rocks for the fire pit, and the next step is to build a firewall that goes all the way across the fire pit.
But yeah, with this shelter, it is super sweet. I'm super lucky to be able to have a little base camp like this. I remember when I thought of it, like, hey, let's make a base camp. The reason I wanted a base camp was so I had a cool area to learn bushcraft skills. Since I built this camp, I got burned out on, you know, construction. So like any bushcrafty skill, I was kind of not wanting to do anymore because I got so many hours put into building. It was like burning my brainy out. But that's what the channel's about, is learning stuff. So I gotta get back to it. I got some cool ideas last night on the internet, some super cool ideas. So once I get this camp settled in after this episode, I'll get back to the Bushcraft A to Z series. I'll get back to doing some more skill related videos. There's just so much cool stuff I'm gonna do. Just a matter of time. All right, enough break, enough BSing. Time to get back to work. Part of the problem with this chair design is that when you sit on it, the back lifts up. So So I've got to figure out a way to wedge these branches up underneath this back wall so that it stays sturdy. And also, maybe make it a little bit more narrow. I'm gonna probably take these lashings off and tighten them down because they're starting to loosen up. Just like my table, all the lashings I did a year ago are really, just from the use, just sitting on it, using the table, are really loosening up. So I'm gonna take the time to tighten those back up.
And I'm thinking the easiest way for me to tighten this lashing is really just to take new paracord and go around like this. What that'll do is it'll pull it all tight. The way I'm gonna do it is a half hitch, three in a row. So one half hitch, just a normal little knot. Wrap it around, do another half hitch, pull that nice and tight, pull it nice and tight, and then just do it again. And they just bite down on each other, they all help each other out. I still really suck. I suck at knots, man. I just can't remember them. It's just like something I do when I'm out camping and bushcrafting, which ain't very often. So it's like really hard for me to recollect exactly how to do all these different types of knots. It's really aggravating to not know how to do knots. By the time, if I spent some time and learned them, it'd be good and fine and dandy. Problem is that if you don't use the skill, practice, you're gonna forget. At one point in time, I knew how to do like 3, 4, 5 different types of knots. But you don't use them, you lose them. Do the same thing over here on this side. Probably don't need quite as much cordage. It was a little bit overkill. Joe's airplane spying on me. All right, and to get the back of this chair, you see back there where it hits the wall? I've got to get some soil dug out so I can dig this chair kind of up underneath the wall. So that way when I sit on it, doesn't get all crazy and doesn't tip on me. I don't need another excuse for me to drop bacon. All right, gonna make everybody mad. I'm gonna use my knife to poke through. That's enough. All right, so now I've got a nice little area here where I can put that log under to keep the chair where it needs to be. Crazy. The seat's so high. I mean, it's not like a real comfortable seat because it's sloped backwards. My feet don't even touch the ground. Maybe get rid of this. Oh, there we go. That's better. Not bad. I'm gonna do the same thing to my little table, is just wrap some paracord around the places where it was already lashed to just kind of tighten it up. Probably tie it right here too, just to keep it a little bit sturdier. So this is good, this is good. This one's not bad. I think it just needs tied to the shelter. Seems as if over the last year or so, I've lost a lot of my
tabletop surface. And it's just like, you don't have a whole lot of flat surfaces out in the woods, so even if it's a little cruddy, rickety little table like this, I think it's still cool. Still provides some value to the camp. All I'm doing is taking little branches and stuff that are, you know, dead wood, but straight enough that I can get them straight across this little thing. Having somewhere to stash your stuff, like back here on this back wall, I'm gonna put some little hooks and stuff so I can keep stuff here at camp without losing it. Having that kind of area is important, I think. It's not gonna be the prettiest table you ever seen, but if it keeps me from losing anything, it's worth it.
All right, well, I got some of these little cross beams on my top put back. I didn't realize it, but this honeysuckle that grows all around here has some nice little 1 foot straight sections. And it's a pest plant, so like I think it'd be a good idea to cut some honeysuckle, put it along the back of this chair to make a little backstop, backrest.
I don't really know if I need the backstop. It's pretty comfortable as it is. Whew, I'm kind of getting tired, man. I need to eat some food. I brought out today noodles and some broccoli and some cauliflower. So I'll probably cook up a little pasta veggie dish here before it gets too late, just to give me some energy to keep going, because I still got a firewall to build, a fire reflector that wraps around that side of the fire. Tinker with the fire pit a little bit. But yeah, I like the camp more like this. I mean, I use it for cooking and hanging out at more than I do sleeping, so I don't need a bed. What I'll probably end up doing is either just sleeping right on the ground, or maybe put together some sort of better raised bed. One that's lower to the ground, that has honeysuckle going across it, give it a little bit of bounce to it, make it more comfortable. Did that cowboy camping with Clint and that was cool. I like just sleeping right on the ground. I could even string the hammock from that dead tree right there to the inside of this. I mean, this shelter is so well built that I could string a hammock to the structure. It would hold my weight.
All right, get this energy, look at this shirt, boy. Get this energy up so I can get to building this little fire reflector. Make this fire reflector bigger. Got some hype, got some inspiration from JoJo's video last night. Him and Mike smoking that meat 3 feet up over the fire got me an idea for a mega tripod with different layers, different levels. So you can have like a low level, you know, for like, get your water boiling quick. High level for like smoking that meat. Like a mid level for, you know what I mean? You can get the picture. So yeah, I'm thinking about making some cooking implements for my fire pit too.
I think it'd be a cool idea. Let's get to it. And luckily I got these big straight pieces for my raised bed to use. Good enough. bad thing about clearing off the ground of all this leaf litter is I feel like it just gets muddy easier. So there it is. There's my first piece cut. I'm gonna run it about this high, about a foot and a half high. The ground right here is just too hard. I don't know what the deal is, but I can't drive a stake in right here, so I have to move it out a little bit, which means the wall won't be as tall. So yeah, I put another fire reflector here just because my fire pit has grown, so the fire reflector needs to grow with it. And what I'm hoping is that it channels air in through my keyhole, my rock cooking area. Take a look at this. All right, probably doesn't look like much from there, but I've got enough rocks collected where I can actually have an entire rock cooking platform stacked on top of other rocks rather than using, you know, rounds and pieces of wood and stuff that will basically burn anyways. So yeah, I've just got this huge pile of rocks over here now, which should be good. Hold in the heat, give the fire reflectors a little bit of extra life. I think all in all, it's good. But yeah, I think these rocks will be crucial, help hold in hold in the heat that the fire creates, bounce it back towards me. I'm hoping that I still get adequate airflow coming from the open woods in through the keyhole fire pit so that I can do more rock cooking. But yeah, I just basically upgraded the campfire area. Spent a little time on it today, and it's looking good. Too bad I don't have anything to cook on it. Have to be another video. All right, I think I'm done working on this camp for the day. If I can get in a quick meal before it gets dark, that's what I'll do. I took out my raised bed, which was right there, and I took out my firewood, moved my table here, and I brought my bush chair in. Sun's going down, enough is enough. I'm done working for the day. Cleaned up a bit more around the camp. It's just a work in progress though, you know? There's always gonna be work to do. So, figure before it gets too late, I'll make some noodles and some veggies to get me some nourishment. Thanks. I was gonna say thanks for watching. All right, I'm gonna get on that. So I'm gonna melt this butter down and then cook up veggies, throw some ramen noodles in it. Real basic meal, basic meal, good meal. All right, you guys can hear it. Ooh, yeah, look at the simmer on that butter bowl. This is my cooking hack. Just don't even use a knife. Just grindy it up like that. Makes it so much quicker. I mean, it's not the most pretty looking dish, but I'm in it for the food. This is like one of my favorite meals. Just broccoli, cauliflower, just a little Montreal steak seasoning, water, butter. Sometimes get fancy, put a little garlic in.
Oh, that looking good.
Oh, man, long day. I think my frying pan ran out of water, so I don't really know how I'm supposed to cook pasta without any water, but it's just ramen, so heck, I've eaten ramen raw before. If you're eating off of a hot pan, put a couple of dirty logs on your pants. It'll keep you from burning your lap.
Loop-dip noodles bowl.
See, it's just ramen noodles and fresh veggies with some butter, infused into the veggies, and some Montreal steak seasoning. It's good. Good eating out in the woods. Yeah, the pasta's like crunchy. It's a little bit not done. It's not all the way done, but makes it good. Mmm.
Look at that.
No autofocus. That's a big chunk of cauliflower wrapped in ramen. Mmm, I did not use the ramen seasoning packet, FYI. Mmm. This is so good. This is like my favorite meal to cook at home. Throw a little chicken in there. But I like to keep it simple when I cook. Keep it simple. I love vegetables. Tried to be a vegetarian before, but it just didn't work out. I couldn't do it. It's not that I don't like veggies. They're good. I like meat a lot. I enjoy the taste of it. You hear that noise? Some type of woodpecker. Ah. Well, that was good. Man, I'm low on steam though. Low on energy. Good day out in the woods, beautiful weather. Awesome temperatures. Not a cloud in the sky. No rain. Got to do some work here at the base camp. Got to cook up a meal. Made some good progress. I can't wait for it to snow, man. Why don't we ever get any snow anymore? Is it because we're on a flat earth? Is it because global warming's real? Is it because global warming's fake and we're on a round earth?
Sorry, battery died.
Look at the hair. Got some hair action nowadays, huh? I don't really know if I like it. Whatever. Yeah, so it was a good day out in the woods. Great day out in the woods. Was able to get another firewall put up, fire reflector, move some stones around. The camp is evolving. That's what you gotta do. You gotta stay loose. Stay ready to move, ready to adapt. I don't know why I thought of this camp as something that had to be set in stone, you know? It's just part of who I am. So I like to be able to make changes. I'm a gray man, not really a binary person. To be able to make my camp move as I see fit is pretty cool. I think it's really cool, actually. I'm wanting it to snow soon, man. I want a good, heavy snowfall. Come out here and do a sweet overnighter. Sit by the fire, sip on some of Grandpa's old cough medicine. Nah, I mean. I'm off my rocker. Ugh. But yeah, good video, good times, good fun, good food, good progress at the camp. I'm rambling on. Time for me to go. Appreciate you guys watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. Till next time, Scrambledo, signing off.